is the bending and twisting load. The body was just used for passenger comfort and was used by almost all the manufacturers. This conventional construction has been replaced by the integral construction or mono construction. In this design, the crucial frame members, which are designed to withstand all loads, are improved into well-designed body panels and fabricated as an integral part of the body. Forces and stresses are distributed and grounded through integrated body panel like box, section channel, body ledges, doors, pillars, roof, and reinforcement members. Therefore, the vehicle body can be classified as a conventional construction in which body and frame are separated, and in integral construction in which the only body exists. The center bulk produced vehicles have transformed the integrated construction. This transformation is the outcome of the necessary body weight reduction and per unit expenditure of the total vehicle. Mass production of the car bodies is carried out by simultaneous manufacturing of different sub-assemblies like floor pan, sides, roof, and cross member. All sub-assemblies are assembled together to one fixture on the assembly line and spot welded to form the complete body cell. The entire body cell as a unit becomes very tough and withstand at all loads in dynamic condition. Now come to the next we discuss on conventional chassis and frame construction. As the picture is shown, the constructional chassis. As mentioned earlier, this type of construction contains separate chassis and body cell as two different assembly. The body cell is then assembled on the chassis with the help of mounting bracket. This assembly is done with rubber boost bolt to hold the body shell to the chassis. This elastic fastener allows the body cell to move a little when the vehicle is in a dynamic condition. Various essential components like engine, wheels, suspension, brake, and transmission are assembled to the chassis. That is, complete chassis unit can be driven. Body cell is assembled to this chassis unit consisting dashboard, seats, engine accessories, doors, etc. Second one is integral car body or integral construction. The term integral or chassis-less construction are often confused, but the difference is simple. Integral construction is that in which a chassis frame is welded to or integrated body with the body. It was the first stage in the evolution of the chassis-less form of construction, in which no chassis frame can be separated. The details of chassis-less construction are too wide-ranging and complex to describe. In principle, however, main advantage of using chassis-less construction is that the strength and stiffness of the property designed body cell are potentially much greater than a chassis frame. One main fact about metal sheet is that even a simple flange provides large load bearing capacity against buckling and or other destruction. So after this take the next topic is defects in vehicle chassis and body. Mostly chassis and body defects arise because of accident, overloading, and driving behaviors. However, 90% collision with obstacle, other vehicle, or pedestrian generates defects in chassis and body rather than driving habit or overloading. As discussed in the chapter of chassis, normal condition wheel on the same axle should be operated parallel with the one another. Rear axle wheel should follow front wheel on steering position, and the tire should meet the road at the correct angle. When a vehicle meets with an accident, it is but obvious that some deformation takes place in the chassis. This deformation depends upon the condition during the accident, with including different direction of locomotive collision, velocity at the time of collision, type of obstacle, safety design of vehicle, etc. Some possible deformation of chassis after meeting with an accident are discussed in the following way. Basically, there are few types. The diamond type damage, banana damage, twist damage, mesh damage, dent and crush. So diamond type damage means when a chassis is subjected to eccentric impact load, probably the chassis may not bend throughout its length. The entire longitudinal member is shifted towards the back, because of which the cross member are misaligned and generate a diamond type defect. Mainly two types of damage: lateral damage and longitudinal damage. Lateral damage: offset take places on the same axle, which means the tire on the same axle remain offset and parallelism has been disturbed in the lateral direction. Next is The next one is banana damage. Banana damage is a result of impact loading on the side, one of the side. High magnitude of impact load causes banana damage. The banana effect is a result of reduction of wheelbase on the impacted side and not by any type of increase in wheelbase. This damage usually results as a decreased gap and heat. One of the major symptoms of damage, banana damage, is the loss of door gap on the impacted side and open gap and feet on the other side. So after the banana damage, the next is twisting damage. Twisting damage arises in conventionally constructed frame. This type of damage is generated from the metal. Or accordion damage, as it is called, is whether the structure collapses in a linear direction. The chassis or body creases and folds either in a finite parts or in a fuse pattern. The effect is like that of an accordion. Figure shows the mesh damage. This is dent and scratches. Then the dent and scratches are generated on outermost skin of the vehicle. These defects spoil the aesthetics of vehicle but do not affect any operation. Accident and bad handling during servicing are main reason of generating dents and scratches on the vehicle body. Dent and scratches are easily repairable and hardly require any part replacement. Next is wheel bores. Just like dents, wheel bores are also surface defect and do not affect any operation. Wheel bores or excess material generated during welding process. It spoils aesthetic of this vehicle. Weld boards method of conducting body repair. This has resulted as increase in amount and performance of body repair with equipment to enhance the traditional methods by used by the workers. Modern equipment are the result of necessarily generated by the integrated body construction of the modern vehicle, which involves causes as alignment the entire construction. Hydraulic body jacks is an essential equipment for the body repair work, which is used to push and pull body panel and components which are in misalignment because of an accident. So, and here is the jack components. What are they? There are extension tube, then head, then jack, then plunger, toe, base, saddle, connector, damper. A body jack consists of three parts: a pump, a flexible hose which is helped to connect the pump to the ram, and the ram unit. Now come to the application of number application of body jack. Where it is applied? It is applied in pushing. Pushing is the piston. Next is spreading. Spreading is also carried out like a pushing. The major difference between the spreading and pushing is that pushing where it adequate space available for admittance of the ram between the two member, which needs to be moved apart. When this is not possible, stretching and tensioning is mean of acquiring a pulling action with the use of push ram. It is different from pushing explained previously, which was a method of applying force to the damaged panel to push them away from each other. In this, the force is given from inside and panel intended to move towards outside. Here, in stretching or tensioning, the reverse action takes place. Pulling is exerted from outside to pull apart those panels which have been drawn in towards each other. The combination used to acquire this exterior